Ladies and gentlemen, will you please welcome to the stage Mr. Bob Monroe and Ms. Tundra from International Truck.
I'd like to introduce our two MCs for our first half of our program, Kenyatta Hearns from our Engine Purchasing Group, and Herb Moore, Local 6, our UAW shop chairman. Come on up, how about a nice warm applause?
Thank you, Bob. And good evening to y'all. Welcome to our International Idol Talent Show. And believe you me, we have a show for you.
Let's give it up for Elizabeth Johnson.
From the neighborhood's walking and when he passes each girl he passes go by. When he walks, he's at the summer, the swing so smooth, swing so lovely that when he passes each girl he passes go by.
Thank you.
will be Earl Baker, better known as Earl the Curve.
Take me to my soul.
she's performing The Creation, a narrative written by James Weldon Johnson.
Good evening. The Creation by James Weldon Johnson. And God stepped out on space, and he looked around and said, "I'm lonely. I'll make me a world." And as far as the eye of God could see, darkness covered everything, blacker than 100 midnights down in a cypress swamp. Then God smiled, and the light broke, and the darkness rolled up on one side, and the light stood shining on the other. And God said, "That's good." Then God reached out and took the light in his hands, and God rolled the light around in his hands until he made the sun. And he set that sun ablazing in the heavens. And the light that was left from making the sun, God gathered up in a shining ball and flung it against the darkness, spangling the night with the moon and the stars. Then down between the darkness and the light, he hurled the world. And God said, "That's good." Then God himself stepped down, and the sun was on his right hand, and the moon was on his left hand. The stars were clustered about his head, and the earth was underneath his feet. And God walked, and where he trod, his footsteps hollowed the valleys out and bulged the mountains up. Then he stopped, and he looked, and he saw that the earth was hot and barren. So God stepped over to the edge of the world, and he spat out the seven seas. He batted his eyes, and the lightnings flashed. He clapped his hands, and the thunders rolled. And the waters above the earth came down. The cooling waters came down. Then the green grass sprouted, and the little red flowers blossomed. The pine tree pointed his finger to the sky, and the oak spread out his arms. The lakes cuddled down in the hollows of the ground, and the rivers ran down to the sea. And God smiled again, and the rainbow appeared and curled itself around his shoulder. Then God raised his arm, and he waved his hand over the sea and over the land. And he said, "Bring forth, bring forth." And quicker than God could drop his heads, fishes and fowls and beasts and birds swam the rivers and the seas, roam the forest and the woods, and split the air with their wings. And God said, "That's good." Then God walked around, and he looked around on all that he made. He looked at his sun, he looked at his moon, and he looked at his little stars. He looked on his world with all of its living things, and God said, And God sat down on the side of the hill where he could think. By a deep, wide river he sat down. With his head in his hands, God thought and thought. Till he thought, "I'll make me a man." Up in the bed of the river, God scooped the clay, and by the bank of the river, he kneeled him down. And there, the great God Almighty, who lit the sun and fixed it in the sky, who flung the stars to the most far corner of the night, who rounded the earth in the middle of his hand. This great God, like a mother bending over her baby, kneeled down in the dust, toiling over a lump of clay, till he shaped it in his own image. Then into it he blew life, and man became a living soul. Amen, amen.
Thank you.
confession.
How's everybody doing? Are you enjoying the show? That's great. Well, we got a second half that's just as good as the first half, if not better. So hang on to your seats and enjoy the second half of the show. So without any further ado, Larry Elvis Shields. That's it.
Of the man. It was a great entertainment. Take off, baby, take off. They go on living without.
I hope they transfer into Mars. Well, I told you I'd program more, and I'll In two more days, it's Monday morning. I've got the Fortran blues. Yeah.
Let's hear it for Diane Dahl and David Lee. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, let's have a big round of applause for Sharon Richmond. Thank you. Next, we have, at this time, our special guest, Melanie Turner Dawson.
Why don't we welcome her? She's going to sing My Kind of Town, Our Love is Here to Stay. Melanie Turner Dawson.
Oh.
coming out today. And to me, Diversity Council is so important. I was so excited when Sharon said she was doing this project. And it's so nice to see a full house tonight. So I really want you to think about the words to the song and try to live every day. The next song is called Our Love Is Here to Stay. It's one of my favorite songs. We're going to start it slow and then speed it up a little bit. But just listen to the words. Try to take it home with you.
Hey, thanks all for coming. One concern that I do have, though, is you know how good these people are on their real job, and I'm concerned that they might find another career after. Thanks again, and the Diversity Council is something that we're going to pay even more attention to in the future. Tanya, thanks for all you do for it. And I think, Joe, it's up to you.
Everybody's welcome to stage. I'm DeVecchio, it's our DJ, and we can dance to the music of DeVecchio.
Yes.